My name is Azael Langa. I'm 29 this year and I'm born and bred in Dayton.
So you graduated with Dayton High School and did you go to
Eastern, what? Eastern School of the Arts.
In high school, with what studies then did you study?
Visual arts. Visual arts. And the other subjects like your sciences. It was complicated because I first did accounting and all those stuff, then for my matric, I did maths and science.
Oh, that's interesting. So, how long have you been doing your art form? What's your art form? What art medium do you do?
Well, I'm a bit diverse, but now, from 2013 until recently, my main focus is smoke drawings. Then I've been practicing, I would say, my earliest memory. My art career was in grade 6 when I first won my art competition, my first art competition, yes. Then I've been practicing until then, from then till today. I grew up in an artistic family where everybody was using hands. My father used to sketch and stuff, but from then I was inspired. That's why I started sketching and stuff. Then, in primary, I had a guy who was older who used to draw cars. Then, from then, that's when now I developed more. Then, when I was doing, I think, my grade six years, I partaked in an art competition. Then, I won it. Then, my teacher from primary prepared me to be an artist. Not established, but he was a practicing artist, Alex. So when Miss McKenzie referred me to him, that's when now I took it a step further. Then went to an art school, then went to TUT, still practicing as well. From my experience, in most institutions like schools, artists by firstly, people who are not really art educated themselves, right? You find that a teacher was teaching science, then they introduce art and culture, then they think art and culture is art, where they have to take those kids and let them play soccer during art and culture and stuff. Then they come back, they teach them how to draw, but the person who teaches them how to draw doesn't even know how to draw, you see, which now is a problem. So, and another thing is with art, in regards to a lot of people, artists whom you think they were established because they started from an early age. Sometimes you find that it depends on how you put your heart into it. Because there are a lot of guys whom you find that one of the artists, well-known artists that I know, that they call on, he practiced easily. I think when he was stage 5, that's when he was established, that's when you practice. And most of the time you think that you have to be established at an earlier age. So education now, the problem with education is that now that they need to introduce artists into the industry where artists have to give back to the community by teaching. Because now you're a practicing artist, you know the industry, you know what's needed. Even though each and every person has their own towards whatever that they want to create, but at least if they see someone from the industry who's going to teach, they get an inspiration from that, then they will grow from it. So the country needs to use artists, because another thing is the fact that art itself is not a stable job. So if they use artists, no matter, even if they didn't go to school, but as long as they know how to practice, they've been in the industry, they know what they're doing, they can use them to go and teach. And with that, then they can get paid, where they give their services, the kids will be inspired. Now it's 50-50, both artists and the kids will benefit from the system. I really want a if I wouldn't say no if she wants to study art, but at the same time, it depends again on because if she studied art, she has to make it by herself, right? I won't be helping her. I need her to get help maybe elsewhere, because I don't want to be that father who feeds, who spoon feeds if I die or something happens to me. She won't be successful or as successful anyway. And at the same time, I want her to look beyond art and see whatever that's out there that she can study. If maybe art can be her hobby for now, it's okay. But I'll support her in whatever decision. But if I'll choose, I'll probably choose for her to study something else. As an artist, I've seen the ups and downs and the stress in art, because believe it or not, art is not just drawing and stuff. It's a gift and a curse. It's emotional, it's a mental state. It needs you to be prepared in all ways. One of the things is through rehabilitation, because when you go to a state, it's more like when the more you're an artist, the more you go into this. If you look at an artist, and there is a difference between a guy who knows how to draw and an artist, right? And the difference between these two people is when you look at an artwork of somebody who knows how to draw, it's just an artwork, right? They know how to draw, they reinterpret whatever image that they want to interpret in their work. But an artist can draw a line, but within that line, their emotions, their feelings, it's a spiritual journey for that artist, and it connects with you as the viewer, right? Then it's more like if you're a dancer, there is someone who can dance and they're just good dancers. But there is someone who dances and transcends you to whatever space that they want you to go to. So that's why, for me, that's art. It's a lifestyle. It's what we need every day. From how I grew up, I could have chosen a lot of things, but because of where I was directed to, I think it helped me a lot. Being an artist, being a young kid introduced into the art industry, because now it shifted my views towards art. Where else I could have maybe been that guy who could have been doing something else. It's a good thing for a community, each and every community, to have an art center where they can go after maybe when they're done with their studies or whatever, they can go there to just do mural activities, where now it can at least benefit them. Then if they don't make it in whatever career that they chose, they can have something to fall on. Because in art, it's difficult to make it. You have to have a heart, you have to fight. And in most cases, you find that some people, because of where you come from, you can't really persist longer in that industry. So you can take it maybe slowly, doing something else on the side and making your art on the side. So if they teach kids to have something that they can make or that they can do with their hands or that can affect their creativity in a better way, I think it's good. Hard, to be honest, to have a distinct signature, or maybe, how can I put it? In a way, like, there is no better artist. Every artist is great in their own way. You just have to have your own signature, which can put you on the side a bit, which can pull attraction to you, a pull sort of attraction, where you can be a bit different. And there is no manual, literally, to say, okay, cool, do this and you'll make it. You find that I can sit here and paint every day and somebody walks in and love my work and that person takes me far. Maybe I have to work hard and travel, go present my work, not get galleries, then I make it. Or just, so in that, I don't think there is really a way to say, okay, cool, this is how you can do it, because my path can be different from another artist's path. So I don't have a right answer to say, okay, cool, do this and you'll make it. The only thing you have to do is you just work hard, produce art and make a piece every day, then with that somebody will recognize you. Somebody, because as I said, art is a spiritual thing. The more you give it time, the more it sends vibrations out there and somebody will hear them. I guess with me when I teach, I look at the child first. I don't just give them what I think it will be good for them. I try and unveil whatever that they want to say to the world. So if you give a child the opportunity to express themselves, let them say whatever they want to say in their own language and guide them towards that language. So if maybe you see that this kid, let's say maybe you find a kid from the township, they're not really equipped, right, first with materials and stuff. You look at the environment and what they can use in the environment to say what they want to say better. Then you guide them to use that to say whatever they want to say. So that's where I come from. Like if you go to a place, I look at where you come from, what you want to say, and what we can use to say what you want to say better. So that's, they are different. There is no specific way of, okay, go, of teaching that child. So I go with that child. So if that child, maybe it's really, and let's say maybe the child wants to make sculptures, but they don't have materials. We look at what he can use, maybe his surroundings, he has cans or whatever that he can find. He can take those fine objects and make a sculpture, but we can guide him to make that sculpture. Pencils and stuff, those are materials that you need to buy. And in most cases, it's difficult for kids from previously disadvantaged communities to have access of those mediums. So we try and bring ways of releasing their creativity without them using those materials. So it's more like recyclable materials to create art. So I think it's mostly advisable to do that in my way, in my own space. And when I teach, when I try and bring those materials for them to even access those materials when I'm not there, to have some kind of accessibility to them, because those are the materials that they see every day. Plastic in art has been used by a lot of artists actually. If you look at, for example, Babu Mbonge Tellis, he uses plastic as well, and his wool is crazy beautiful. So that's the first example that you can look at and how plastic can be used. And you come back, you look at the Ndebele cultures, how they weave mats and start using plastic, right? You come back, you look at some artists who make flowers. Like going to this art Saturday art classes, would use plastic to make flowers and stuff, which those can be sold, right? And it's easier now to take that material and sell it to an average Joe, a local in the township. People have more, they're familiar with those mediums, like with those products. If you look at flowers, you look at mats and some of the things, decorative projects that you get, things that you can make for households. So first you look at even the individuals in the townships, not only in the townships, but back in rural areas, right? You can use plastic, you can bring, you can give them some kind of jobs, because if you look at most old grannies in townships or in rural areas, they don't have things to do. You can bring plastics and they're really equipped with knowledge of how to weave. They can start weaving using plastic, which has been done, but now it's forgotten. They can start doing that again, and those can be sold, right? Coming back to townships, kids can start using that to create their, you can even create shoes, because when I grew up, we used to create flip-flops using plastics and stuff. Those can be created and sold for tourists and stuff. They can make art out of that. You can bring them to people like Mbongeni Tellis for inspiration, that they can see that this can be created and they can sell it for thousands. So plastic has a bigger market in the art industry that people need to tap into. So if I could say maybe if plastic, if I could get a chance to use it, I could like, for example, some of my works, yes, in a bed, maybe it can be bed, but I bend plastic to get the fumes of that plastic to create some of the works, even directing the smoke to a better place. That's what I'm saying.
Yeah.
There are downfalls in it, because if maybe you can have a great ventilation in a room where it, because you find that some fans can clean air and bring it out in a nice way. So if you find those things, which is going to be expensive, but I bend plastic to create some of my works, then I can teach some people how to make art, because I used to make sculptures out of plastic. One of my projects in, when I was doing my second year, I was recycling plastic, which from that project I did a guest lecture on recycling plastic and stuff. So I think it just now needs people to be aware of what's happening around them so they can know what to use, because knowledge is there, they just need to